Consider the lifting flow over a circular cylinder with a lift coefficient equal to 5. What we want to do is calculate the peak negative pressure coefficient as well as find the locations of the stagnation points and where pressure is equal to P static. Now, what we can start out by doing is write out the velocity terms for each of our two flow patterns. So we have V is equal to negative 2 times V infinity minus gamma divided by 2 pi r, where V infinity is our free stream velocity and gamma is the strength of the vortex. So now the non-lifting flow, well, that is contributing this negative 2 V infinity here, whereas the vortex flow, that is contributing this negative gamma divided by 2 pi r. So you're essentially just taking superposition and just adding them together, just combining the velocities at the surface of your sphere. So now, what we can do next is we can work with the little hint that they gave us that the lift coefficient is equal to 5. So now, we're saying that CL is equal to 5, but CL can also be related to gamma divided by R times V infinity. So now this can be rewritten as gamma divided by r, which is equal to 5 times the free stream velocity. So now the next step that we can do is we can plug in our gamma divided by r into the equation for v, such that v is equal to negative 2 times v infinity minus 5 divided by 2 pi times v infinity. So that leaves us with negative 2.796 times v infinity. And now the next step that we need is to essentially bring in our coefficient of pressure equation, or CP equation. So now this is going to be equal to 1 minus V divided by V infinity squared. And then all we have to do is plug in V. And then after evaluating, we get a CP of negative 6.82. So we have one part of this problem already completed. So now the next step is to solve for the stagnation points. So now, what we can start out by doing is we can write out our V theta. So in polar coordinates, we'll essentially have our theta direction and our R direction. So now we can take our velocity from before and we can essentially write it out into our polar coordinates, such that V theta is going to be equal to negative 2 V infinity sine theta minus gamma divided by 2 pi r. And now since we're saying we're looking for stagnation points with a velocity, it's going to be 0 for both v theta and vr. So we can say that v theta equals 0 at stagnation point. So the next thing that we can do is we can essentially solve for what theta is going to be. So we can say that sine theta going to be equal to negative gamma divided by 4 pi r v infinity. And then by taking the inverse sine of both sides, we get that theta is equal to sine inverse of negative gamma divided by 4 pi r v infinity. So next what we can do is we can say from before, gamma over R V infinity was equal to 5, which is equal to CL. So we can make that substitution and we say that theta is equal to sine inverse of negative 5 divided by 4 pi. So now we can actually solve for what theta is. So we get that theta is equal to 203.4 degrees and 336.6 degrees. So those will actually be the stagnation points along our cylinder here. Okay, so now the next step that we have is to solve for when the pressure is equal to the static pressure. So what we can essentially do is we can start out with the CP equation again, such that we have CP is equal to 1 minus V divided by V infinity squared, where V is equal to negative 2 V infinity sine theta minus gamma divided by 2 pi r. Now, what we can do is we can substitute. It's going to be a little bit of algebra here. So essentially divide V by V infinity. And that'll all be squared. So then we can essentially just factor this out. And then by factoring it out, we should get something like this, where we get 1 minus 4 times sine squared theta minus 10 divided by pi sine theta minus 5 divided by 2 pi squared. And now the reason we got that is because we made the substitution with the gamma over r times v infinity as being equal to 5. Where essentially, this part here is equal to 5. So that's how that cleaned up the bottom a little bit. So now, what we can then do is we can essentially combine terms. So we'll get CP is equal to 0.367 minus 3.183 sine theta, and then minus 4 sine squared theta. So what we can actually do real quick is we can actually double check when theta is equal to 90 degrees, because when it's equal to 90 degrees, we should technically get our minimum CP, because that'd be at the top of this cylinder right here. So that's where the velocity will be the fastest, more than likely. And then, since it'll be the fastest, we'll have the lowest pressure. So we can actually double check that. So we say double check at theta equals 90 to get our minimum CP. So we can actually do that real quick. We can say CP is going to be equal to 0.367 minus 3.183 sine of 90, which is going to be 1, minus 4 times sine of 90 squared, which is also going to be 1. And that leaves us with negative 6.82. So we actually get the same thing, which is kind of cool. And it's a good way to double check to make sure that the previous process that we did was correct. So, okay, back to the P equals P infinity. So when P is equal to P infinity, or a static pressure, well, CP is going to have to be equal to 0, because we know that P is equal to P infinity plus CP times Q infinity. So we can write that back out. So we know now CP is going to be equal to 0. So we have 0 is equal to our 0.367 minus 3.183 sine of theta minus 4 sine squared of theta. Now to solve this, we're going to be solving for sine of theta, and we're going to have to use the quadratic formula. So we'll do that real quick. Okay, and then from this, we get negative 0.897 or 0.102. So this will actually leave us with four different thetas. So we'll start writing those out. So we'll essentially have theta is equal to 243.8 degrees and 296.23 degrees. And the way we're getting these is just by taking inverse sine of both of these, and then just reflecting across our, essentially our y-axis. And then we also get that theta is equal to 5.85 degrees and 174.1 degrees. So now, one thing that we can also do is we can actually calculate the local min at theta equal to 3 pi divided by 2, because why not, right? So we can say, let's calculate theta equals 3 pi over 2 for local min at bottom. So we can do that real quick. So essentially what we'll have is CP equal to 0.367 minus 3.183 sine of 3 pi divided by 2 minus 4 times sine squared of 3 pi divided by 2. And then we get a local minimum CP at the bottom of the cylinder at negative 0.45. And then we actually have a quick image of this below to see what it looks like. So we essentially have our cylinder here, and then we have our flow flowing over the cylinder. And then notice these flow lines, or these stream lines, that essentially go to the cylinder and then just stop. Now those would actually be the stagnation points. And then we actually have the degree to figure out where those are. So we can plot them out and then figure out what those would be. And then we also have our 4 points here, noted in kind of like the cyan blue, where pressure is going to be equal to P infinity. And remember, we have 4 different parts of those. And then also from before, we said at 90 degrees, right? So if we start with this being our 0 theta, and then we rotate 90 degrees, that's when we get our minimum CP, which is going to be at the top of our cylinder, because that's where the flow is moving the fastest. So then the pressure will essentially decrease the most compared to everything else. And then compared to the bottom here, that's where our local min will be in the bottom of the cylinder. It won't be quite as low as the pressure at the top of the cylinder. But yeah, it's just a good visual to see, just kind of connected everything together.